Hello everyone, and welcome to the third video of the first lecture of the course on metric spaces. In the last videos, we defined a distance on the plane, and we worked through the definition of a ball in this metric space. So let us recall what we did. We had R2 with x and y coordinates. Let me draw the axis. So this is the y axis, and this is the x axis. And given 2 points, P equal to xp, yp, where xp is the x coordinate and yp is the y coordinate, and q equal to xq, yq, and we can represent these points in the picture we draw, p and q, then we said that the distance between p and q, one of the two distances we defined, is given by the square root of xq minus xp squared plus yq minus yp squared. And then we said that given any point P, a point, and a number r, which is positive, then we can define the ball B centered at P of radius R to be the set of points in the plane Q such that the distance between P and Q is at most R. These are the things we did last time, whereas in this video we will go through some other examples of distances on the plane and some very strange behavior of these distances, which is far from what we used to think when we measure distances in real life. The first example we are going to see is the distance which is called the P distance. So we fix P, a number, between 1 and infinity, which means that it's just a number that is greater or equal than 1 and it's smaller than infinity. So it's any number bigger or equal than 1. Then we define the distance between P and Q, where P and Q have coordinates xp, yp, xq, yq, to be equal to the pth root of the absolute value of xq minus xp to the p plus yq minus yp to the p. So first of all, let us notice that if you take p equal to 2, then we get the same distance as before. Indeed, you can just replace p with 2 and you can see that it's exactly the square root of xq minus xp squared plus yq minus yp squared. Moreover, if you take p equal to 1, then you get that the distance between p and q is given by the modulus of xq minus xp plus yq minus yp. And this is the taximetric we defined at the end of the last video. So these distances, which depend on the integer p we fixed, recover when we fix p equal to 1 and p equal to 2, the two distances we had already seen. Now, I'm claiming that this formula here actually defines a distance, but this is far from being trivial, at least when you take p different from 1 and p different from 2. The hard part is to prove the triangle inequality, which requires a very important inequality called the Minkowski inequality. You will have the chance in the exercises to work with this distance and to try and prove that it is actually a distance. However, the example we are going to look at now is not this distance, but it's another one, which has a very interesting name. I will tell you after I've explained how to define the distance. So let's say that we are a point in the plane. So I'll draw the axis once more. And let's say that we are a point P in the plane. And let's say that we want to go to Q. But in order to move from P to Q, we need, and it's not something we can choose not to, we need to go through the origin. So if I want to move from P to Q, I can't go straight in this way. This is not allowed. I need to go through the origin, and then from the origin I need to move to Q. So I need to go this way, from P to O, and then from O to Q. I cannot move directly from P to Q. Under this restriction, I want to define the distance from P to Q as the distance from P to the origin in the metric we defined in the first example, plus the distance between the origin and Q in the metric we defined in the first example. So this distance will be the square root of xp minus 0 squared plus yp minus 0 squared plus the square root of xq minus 0 squared plus yq minus 0 squared, that we can rewrite as the square root of xp squared plus yp squared plus the square root of xq squared plus yq squared. This is a new distance that takes into account the fact that for moving from a point P to a point Q, I necessarily have to go through the origin. This metric is also called the French railroad metric, and you will have the chance to work with this metric during the exercises as well. Now, what I want to do now is to try and compute the distance between two points in this metric. Why do I want to do this? Because it will show that it measures distances in a way we are not used to think. Let's say we want to compute the distance between two points, the point 1, 1 and the point 2, 1. Using the formula we have written down, this is the square root of 1 squared plus 1 squared plus the square root of 2 squared plus 1 squared. And this is the square root of 2 plus the square root of 5. This is a very strange number, because if we were using the standard distance we used since the beginning, which computes the distance computing the length of the segment connecting two points, then we would get a different answer. Try to work it out yourself if you want to compare the two numbers. But what we want to do now is to try and take two other points which are actually near, in the sense that we can draw them near to each other, as for example 1, 1 and 2, 1, because if you draw the axis once more, then you can see that the point P11 is here and the point 21Q is here. So we can draw them near to each other, but the distance is not that small. Let's say we want to try and compute the distance between the point 10, 1 and the point 12, 1. Then, once again using the formula, this will be 10 squared plus 1 squared under square root plus square root of 20 squared plus 1 squared. And this is the square root of 101 plus the square root of 401. This number can be explicitly computed, but you can see that it's bigger than 10 plus 20. So this number here is bigger than 30. However, if you draw the two points in the plane, you can see that these two points are not that far apart. So if this is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, then we have 12, 14, 16. I need to make it longer. 18, 20. Then the points are here and here. So they're not so near, but they're not even this far. And if you were to try and compute the distance between 10, 1 and 11, 1, then you would still get the square root of 101 plus the square root of 122, which is still bigger than 21. So in this case, the two points would be here and here, and they would be very near. They can be drawn very near, but their distance is very big. The reason why this is happening is that we're forcing, in order to compute the distance between two points, to start from one of the two points, go to the origin, and then come back. And this makes distances grow bigger, even if the points can be drawn very near to each other. You will have the chance to look at these examples and more examples in the exercises. So have a look at them and have fun. See you in the next lecture.